So, a box arrived for me the other day. Let's open it up and see what's inside. A little over a year and a half ago, I jumped into the rabbit hole of Homelabs, thanks mostly in part to Craft Computing and Network Chuck. Being a beacon of moderation, I decided to dive feet first into this area and purchased a recently decommissioned HP server, then a Supermicro GPU server, and then another Supermicro server. I might have a problem. Anyhow, the learning curve for these systems was high, which leads me to the topic of today's video. When you're a first-time home labber, it would probably be wiser to start off simple and cheap. Learn to set up networks, deploy virtual machines, run Docker containers, whatever you want to do, in a low-power, quiet system to build your confidence before jumping down the rabbit hole that it can quickly become. There are a lot of options out there, from Intel NUCs to Raspberry Pis and everything in between. I came across this HP microcomputer while scrolling through my suggestions on eBay, and at $70, I couldn't pass it up. Now, opening the box, the seller included an HP mouse and a keyboard, 90-watt power brick, Wi-Fi USB adapter, and a DisplayPort to VGA adapter. The system itself sports an i5-7500T, which is a 4-core, 4-thread processor running at 3.2 GHz. It came with 8 GB of RAM, which I'm assuming was in a single channel configuration, so I purchased a second 8GB stick just to be safe. It also has a 1TB hard drive. As this is a third generation system, this is a physical hard drive, however, newer generations come with standard SSDs. As far as IOs go, it's decent. It has two USB ports up front, along with a headphone and microphone jack. It also has four more USB ports on the back of the system, and two display ports. Though one of these ports is an expandable one, so you could remove it and replace it with other capabilities. You just have to check out HP to see what options they have for that little adapter port. There's also a serial connector on there too, in case you need to interface with any older hardware. Let's open up the system. This is super easy. You just unscrew the one screw on the back and push the top of the case forward. Once open, we can see the hard drive and the fan. The RAM is located under the fan, so we'll just lift that up and yep, just as I thought, a single stick of RAM. So let me add the other one and then we'll button this back up and get to setting it up. There. Now it's all back together. I'll add the mouse, keyboard, Wi-Fi module, and connect it to my monitor. This came with Windows pre-installed, so I'm not going to use another operating system. Though, with the specs of the machine, I think a Linux install would probably function better, since Linux can run on a potato, and Windows needs more resources. However, if you're new to Homelabs, you may not have much experience with Linux, so making it the main operating system might increase the learning curve a bit. Now that Windows is set up and I have OSB installed, let's walk through this setting this up and we'll set up a virtual machine. Now, there are many ways to run virtual machines, but we're going to use a program called VirtualBox. This is what's known as a Type 2 hypervisor, as it installs on an existing operating system and manages virtual machines from the operating system's environment. This makes it nice and easy for someone just starting out with virtualization. With VirtualBox up and running, I just need to add a new machine. I'm going to create a Linux machine since for this video we are going to be setting up a Minecraft server. I have several people here who like to play Minecraft, so setting up a dedicated home server not only saves the player computer's resources, but also makes it to where people can get on at any time. For this, I am going to use an installation of Linux Mint. I like this operating system, especially since it feels a lot like Windows. So someone who is new to Linux should be able to start out comfortably. I downloaded the ISO file from Linux Mint's website. Then after pointing the new machine setup to the ISO file, we just have to define a few more things. Since I have 4 cores to work with, I'm only going to be giving the virtual machine 2, which should still be plenty. Again, Linux can run on practically anything. I'm also going to give it 6 gigabytes of RAM. Also, if you want your network to access the virtual machine easily, you should set the network option up as a bridged connection. Now, we'll let this bake. Once that's done, we'll launch our virtual machine and run through a few steps. Don't worry, I'll post all of the commands below in the description. Okay, you want to open up a terminal. There's an icon on the taskbar, or you can right-click anywhere on the desktop and find the option that says Open Terminal. First, we will type sudo apt update and hit enter. It will ask for our password and then scan for any updates. There should be quite a few for the first time after a fresh installation. When that's done, we will type sudo apt upgrade dash y. Again, hit enter, and this will install all of those updates. The next step is to set this up with SSH so I can access the server from another computer. So now we will type sudo apt install SSH and hit enter again. This will install the SSH client. Since we are running Minecraft Java Edition, we need to install our Java environment. This is done with sudo apt install openjdk-17-jre-headless and hit enter. Now, we're going to install a module called screen. This just lets us run the server on a fresh screen that we can disconnect from in case we want to do other things on the virtual machine while the Minecraft server is running. So we type sudo apt install screen and hit enter. Now that that's done, we want to make sure that our firewall allows other players to connect to the server. So we will add an exception to the port for Minecraft, which is by default port 25565. To do this, we type sudo ufw allow 25565 and hit enter. Now all we have to do is go get the Minecraft server from its official download page by opening up a web browser and going to https://www.minecraft.net/download/server. On there, you're going to right click on the download link and select copy link. Now we go back to our terminal and type wget and paste the link in and then hit enter. This will pull the server and install it on the virtual machine. Once that's done, let's go ahead and type screen and hit enter. This gives us a fresh new window. Next, we are going to start the Minecraft server. So type sudo java-xms1Gspace-XMX4Gspace-JAR Space server.jar Space no GUI and hit enter. The tags -XMS and -XMX tell the server the minimum and maximum amount of RAM, so it's allowed to use these respectively. In this case, I'm telling it to use no less than 1 GB of RAM and no more than 4 GB. The no GUI option just means that the server will run on this screen instead of trying to open up another application. Once the server builds, it will close because we need to accept the EULA. To do this, we're going to type nano space EULA dot txt and hit enter. This will open a very basic editor. We need to key over and change EULA equals false to BULA equals true. Then we hit Control X, Y, and Enter. Now we redo our run command, that sudo java-xmx-s1g-xmx-4g-jar-server.jar no GUI, and there you go. The Minecraft server is up and running. To connect to it, you will need to note the virtual machine's IP address by going to network settings, copy that down. Now, let me jump over to my gaming system, get connected, and see if it worked. And here we are. You're on your way down the rabbit hole of Homelabs. You're welcome, and have fun. Thank you a lot for checking out this channel. Please like the video, subscribe, hit the bell for notifications, do all the YouTube things, and follow for more videos. I hope to see you in the next one.